The graph below shows the depreciation of a motorcycle's value over time. And they show us the graph, and they say during which 2-year span does the most rapid, let me underline that, the most rapid depreciation occur. So depreciation just means loss in value. And this shows the motorcycle's value. And you can just eyeball this here. Let's just look what this chart's saying. This is saying right when the motorcycle is brand new, when it's 0 days old, or 0 years old, I should say, it is worth $10,000. And then when it's 1 year old, it looks like it's about a little over $6,000. And when it's 2 years old, it looks like it's about, I don't know, 5,000, then at 3 years, it's about 4,000, and so on and so forth. So this curve shows how it depreciates, how it loses its value. And they're saying, when is the most rapid depreciation occurring? And they don't want to just know what year. They want a 2-year span when we have the most rapid depreciation. Now, one thing you can look here, you can just kind of eyeball, and you can say, look, the beginning of this curve is the steepest part. It's steepest over these 2 years than over any other 2-year period. Out here, it's a kind of a very shallow, it's almost flat in terms of how quickly it's losing value. So it's not losing value too quickly. So if you just eyeballed it, you would just say, well, it's the most rapid depreciation is occurring over the first 2 years, from 0 to 2 years up to this point, because you can see the curve is getting less and less steep the entire time, but it's most steep over those first 2 years. Now, if you didn't want to just eyeball it and really verify that it loses the most value over the first 2 years than any other 2-year period, let's actually calculate it. So let me write 2-year period, and let's write lost value. Or we could call it depreciation, either way. So from 0 to 2 years, we went from $10,000 to what looks like about $5,000, right? That looks right about $5,000. So we lost $5,000 of lost value. Then if we go from 1 to 3 years, what happened? 1 to 3 years, that's the other 2-year period. You go from 1 to 3 years, we started, it looks like at about 6,100, maybe 6,200 or so, and we went to 4,000. So we lost about, I don't know, $2,200. We lost about $2,200. So definitely less than what we lost in the first 2 years. And then if we look at the second through the fourth year, we went from about 5,000 to about 4,000. So we lost about, looks like about 1,000. Looks like about $1,000 in value. Maybe a little less. Well, yeah, that's about what we went from years 2 to 4. Two or about 5,000, or maybe a little under 4,000. So I'll give it a little bit more value. So maybe it's like 3,800 right there. So maybe on the order of $1,200. And then if you go from year three to year five, we're going from about $4,000 to looks like about 3,600. If I had to eyeball it, so it looks like we lost about $400. So if anything, as we go further and further in time, each 2-year period, we're losing less value. So then finally, if we go from 4 to 6 years, looks like we're at about, I don't know, 3,800, and we end up at about, I don't know what this value looks like. It's about 30, I would say it's maybe 3,500, or maybe we're going from 37. I don't know. We're losing about 300. It's steep, it's shallower than it was before. So the most rapid depreciation occurs in the first 2 years. And you didn't have to go through this exercise. You could have just looked at the chart. You could say, hey, look how steep it is this first 2 years compared to all of the years after that.